Welcome to the great outdoors in Evans, Colorado. I'm Colleen Knight. This is
Ryan Specht here. Today we're looking at the WILDWOOD 31KQBTS.
Hey Ryan, what does that stand for?
I believe it is outdoor kitchen, quad bunk, and a triple slide.
So smart. This camper weighs 8,719 pounds dry, GVWR of 9,865 pounds.
Some other important stats you want to think about when you're looking at travel trailers is the size of your water tanks. This guy comes in with 40 gallons for your fresh water, 54 gallons for your gray or wastewater, and then 34 gallons for all your black or your toilet tank water.
Right here we have two 20-pound tanks. Power tongue jack with a light. This is a great feature. If you happen to come into your campsite at night, you can actually see what you're doing. Another thing to point out real quick on this unit, we have a little bit of hail damage, so that'll give you a nice discount.
All right, let's cover some features on your campsite side of the 31KQBTS. First off, you've got a really nice size pass-through storage area here. You are able to get to that from inside too by tipping up the bed. Right below that, you've got the pre-wire for solar panels. So if that's something you decided to do, it's simple plug and play system. We sell them in our parts store anywhere from 40 to 160 watts, help keep a trickle charge on your battery. And as we continue along, I'd like to point out the really nice solid steps that WILDWOOD has started using. These things are great for a few reasons. First off, they land solid on the ground with extendable and retractable legs so that no matter what terrain you're on, you can land it solid on the ground. I also like the fact you only have one moving hinge instead of several like you do on the traditional camper stairs, and it all folds up inside so it's not outside exposed to the road elements when you're going down the road. And right here, we've got a 6-gallon hot water heater. It is a direct spark ignition, so all you got to do inside is hit the button and that sucker is going to get you hot water, recovering it 16.2 gallons an hour. What else do we have, Colleen?
Right above our heads, we have an electric awning with nice LED lights lighting up the backside of it. We also have outside speakers. And right over here, we have an outside kitchen. I can't get it to open all the way because of the fence, but you have a nice plumbed sink in here. Nice size outside refrigerator. And then right around the corner is your grill, which swivels around to be right near your kitchen area. Right up here, we're pre-wired for a backup camera, full-size spare, and your city water connection.
Then right over here on this side of the coach, you've got the hookup for your 30-amp service. Comes with a 25-foot power cord that just simply screws on there. And if you happen to have a portable satellite or you're at a park that offers cable, one of these is piped into the bedroom and one is piped into the main living room where the TV hookup's at. All right, come on inside and let's show you some of the features on the inside of this WILDWOOD 31KQBTS.
Starting in the living and dining area, right here we have a nice couch with some storage underneath. This couch folds out for extra sleeping space. We also have nice storage above it. Nice inlaid glass for a little bit of a decoration feature. We have nice and smooth roller shades. Exit window. Over here we have a U-shaped dinette. This turns into a sleeping area as well. Right above here we have some nice accent light. Over here we have some storage. This is nice pantry storage. And then we have LED lights throughout the cabin.
All right, and as we rotate around to the other side of the coach here, we're in the kitchen. So you've got a really nice gas electric refrigerator here, separate freezer, plenty of storage for, you know, a weekend or a long trip away with the family. Nice three burner cooktop. I really like the way that they set this up above the countertop. Sometimes when you have that recess below the countertop, you can't put those larger pots and pans on it, so having it up above like this is a nice feature. Also a little built-in knife rack on the back, a hood that is actually vented outside of the camper to help get rid of those smells and if you happen to burn the toast or something. Nice little microwave up above. Good storage up here, plenty of room for all your dishes and your accessories for when you're camping. I also like to point this out here. Everything is actually screwed and glued together. It's not just stapled together as you see these screws here, which is pretty important when you're going up and down the road. Staples have a tendency to work their way out. Nice high-rise faucet here, and you do have a double basin in the sink with Colleen's Batman coffee cup right in here. Really nice solid surface countertops as well.
Moving towards the back of the coach, we have the bathroom. You have a good size sink, full size medicine cabinet, nice size shower, skylight, lights, an exhaust fan.
All right, now here on the front side of the coach is where your entertainment center's at. This guy is set up for a pretty good sized TV. I think you can go up to about 40 inches with a flat screen TV, actually 42 it says right here. And then down below you've got some pretty good storage, a nice spot for games or DVDs, things of that nature. This is gonna be your built-in stereo, Bluetooth capable, indoor and outdoor speakers that'll play off of it. Right here, right inside the entry door, you also have all your controls. So you'll have the meters to check all your tanks and your batteries and stuff, controls for your slides and your awnings. One of the neatest things about the Wildwood too is all that stuff can actually be operated from this remote as well. So once you unhook from the truck, you can literally set up your whole camper with this little remote. Now let's go in the bedroom and join Colleen as she points out a few of those features for you.
Starting off right here, we have a place for a second TV. You're what pre-wired over here for it. We have great storage on the side. Jeans, t-shirts, and then more storage right here. You have a hanging bar, lots of space to put stuff. One more feature I wanna point out over there is a pass-through laundry chute. You can put your laundry basket outside. And then underneath there you have storage. Great Denver mattress for your sleeping. Great LED lights. And then your, of course, your air conditioning vented right into your bedroom.
All right, now to my favorite part of the 31KQBTS. Colleen, come check this out. Talk about a bunk room. Man.
This is massive.
You got a bunch of rugrats and you need somewhere to lock them away. This is the perfect spot. Opposing slide outs, quad bunks back here. And these aren't the tiny little skinny bunks either. Mm-hmm. An adult could sleep on these easily.
Nope.
Another thing that's really nice is they've got their own air conditioner in here dedicated to this area. So the first AC is ducted throughout, but this one is dedicated to the bunk room. Tell me about some of this stuff.
They have an awesome storage area. There's plenty of space here for any of the clothes that you would need for them. There's also plenty of space for all of their toys. There's so much room on this floor down here. There's enough room for board games or whatever they want to do. A wrestling match, whatever.
they can totally do that. And their own TV hookups too. Yeah. So hopefully, ideally, you're outside most of the time when you're camping, but if the weather forces you in and you got a bunch of kiddos, it's nice to have a space to stick them.
This is a great place to put them. Thanks for taking the time to watch us here at the Great Outdoors RV in Colorado. I'm Colleen Knight.
I'm Ryan Specht. If you have any questions, feel free to share them in the comments section below or just give us a call, 970-313-4337, or you can pop me an email, ryan@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com or
Colleen@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.
Thanks, guys.